Now we'll look at some examples of solving quadratic equations equal to constants graphically. We want to use the graph of f of x equals x squared minus 2, graphed here in red, to solve f of x equals 7. Let's first set up the equation that we're actually trying to solve. Since f of x is equal to x squared minus 2, we'll perform a substitution here to create our equation. We would have x squared minus 2 for f of x. We want to know when this is equal to positive 7. And to solve this graphically, instead of setting it equal to 0, we're going to use the intersection method this time. So again, we're already given the graph of f of x equals x squared minus 2, which is the left side of the equation. Now what we're going to do is set the right side of the equation equal to g of x. So we'll graph the function g of x equals 7, and then these two will be equal where the functions intersect. Well, g of x equals 7 is a horizontal line passing through the y-axis at 7, or this horizontal line here. Again, this is g of x, and this is f of x. Graphically, we can see they're equal at this point of intersection and at this point of intersection. This point of intersection has coordinates 3, 7. And this point of intersection has coordinates negative 3, 7. So this point is telling us that when x is equal to 3, both functions are equal to 7, which satisfies the equation. So one solution is x equals 3. This point here is telling us that when x is equal to negative 3, both functions are also equal to 7, which would satisfy this equation as well. So we have two real rational solutions. Let's take a look at another example. Here we want to use the graph of f of x equals x squared minus 2x plus 1 to solve f of x equals 4. So again, we'll start by setting up our equation. We'll substitute x squared minus 2x plus 1 for f of x. We want to know when this is equal to positive 4. And again, the given graph is f of x equals x squared minus 2x plus 1, which is the left side of the equation. So now we'll graph the right side of the equation as g of x, and then determine when these two functions are equal to each other or where they intersect. Well, g of x equals 4, again, is another horizontal line passing through the y-axis at 4, which would be this horizontal line here. Again, this is g of x, and this is f of x. The two functions are equal here at this point of intersection, as well as this point of intersection. The coordinates of this point of intersection are 3, 4, and the coordinates of this point of intersection are negative 1, 4. Notice when x is 3 and when x is negative 1, both functions are equal to 4, which represent the solutions to our equation. So our solutions are x equals 3 or x equals negative 1. And again, we have two real rational solutions. Okay, let's take a look at one more example. We want to use the graph of f of x equals negative x squared plus 2, graphed here in red, to solve f of x equals 6. So the equation we're trying to solve would be negative x squared plus 2, which is f of x, equals 6. We're provided the graph of f of x here in red. So we'll let the right side of the equation equal g of x, and then look for the points of intersection. Again, g of x equals 6 would be a horizontal line passing through 6 on the y-axis, or this line here. So here's g of x, and here's f of x. We'll notice that these two functions are never equal to each other because they don't intersect, which means that this equation has no real solutions. So we cannot solve this graphically, but we could try to solve this algebraically. So let's go ahead and do that. So we're going to try to solve x squared plus 2 equals 6. Let's go ahead and subtract 2 on both sides. So we'd have negative x squared equals positive 4. If we divide both sides by negative 1, we would have x squared equals negative 4. And now if we take the square root of both sides of the equation, We'd have a plus or minus sign here. We would have x equals plus or minus the square root of negative 4. Well, the square root of negative 4 is equal to the square root of negative 1 times 4. Well, the square root of negative 1 would be I. The square root of 4 would be 2. So we have x equals plus or minus 2i, which are imaginary numbers. And that's the reason why we did not have a point of intersection on the coordinate plane. Both the x and the y axis represent real number lines. So these would be our two solutions to the given equation. So to be more specific, we can say this equation has two imaginary solutions or complex solutions. Remember, all imaginary numbers are also complex numbers. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.